Twitter, Boy Williams. Of course, you know, Royalty Radio, www.royaltyradio.ca, 91.9 FM every Tuesday to 10, www.cfireradio.com. Right now, we're here with the man of the
Era,
tell him what it is.
Yo, what up, man? I appreciate you guys coming out. Listening party, you know what I'm saying? Jamie Era, no handouts, listening session. We just want to play some music for some people. Let the tastemakers know what was up, you know what I mean? I put out the mixtape on the 16th, but I just want to play it for my city, live and direct, be here in the flesh, you know what I mean? Let people know what was up with some of the records, some of the features here. Shout out Shot Wisdom in the building, my man Snaz in the building, you know what I'm saying? Like, a lot of people, Tribes came out, you know, Cardi came out, my man Apple came out. Like, shout out to everyone showing me mad love. Toronto, I love you. You know what I'm saying? So it starts from me and it goes right back to you.
Definitely. Of course, fresh off the tour.
Yeah.
How was the tour?
Yo, the tour was crazy. We got to do, I did like 13 dates in Canada, and that was like a good little warm-up run, you know what I mean, to get my energy right and get ready for the States. And then we did like, I think, 30, 35 dates in the U.S. Off the top, I don't remember. It was like 35 dates in the U.S. Got to go everywhere from like Pontiac, Michigan, the middle of nowhere, you know what I'm saying? To like fucking, we did New York, BB King's, which was like center stage, you know what I mean? When it comes to New York City, that's like center stage. So just going around was a crazy experience, and everywhere I went on some real shit, like I was representing Canada, like people are like, yo, by the end of the show, like, yo, you from Toronto? Yo, you from Canada? You know what I mean?
Canada,
like, Canada, yo, you from Canada, hey, yo. You know what I mean? So it was dope, yeah, just to kind of get around and show love.
For sure. Now, of course, in terms of the tracks you performed and everything like that, mm-hmm. was there a particular track that they gravitated towards the most? Which one?
For the first half of the tour, we were doing more Unexpected Victory joints, you know what I mean? So I got like 5 joints on Raekwon's tape, go download that Unexpected Victory, but from those joints, they loved Luxury Rap and like Soldier Story, that was their shit. I was doing Payday in the middle of, you know what I mean, some of the sets, and towards the end of the tour, I got to do some stuff off of the mixtape. Doing Smoking Good at BB King's was definitely special. That was like, yeah, Ray, because Ray hit me with that shit like out the blue, you know what I mean? Like certain records are Ray's favorites, so he be like doing shit just to kind of surprise me. So he played Smoking Good out the blue and I performed that. I was ill.
Okay.
BB King's.
Most
definitely.
Now, speaking about the No Handouts and Mixtape, you guys have Yoga Flame on there.
Yeah.
That's been there since 18. You know, we've been waiting for a long time.
19 hours.
You know what I'm saying,
yo.
Man? It's been there so long, I'm getting great hairs now.
Yeah.
It's all good, man. It's all good. At the end of the day, what was the delay in that? Why did you guys wait to actually put it out on No Handouts as opposed to releasing it early?
For me, it was too big a record to just let go on its own, like with no project, you know what I mean? Like I really wanted, like Yoga Flame was a dope record on its own, but I really wanted it to be, I knew it was a piece of the body of work, you know what I mean? So I just wanted it to be a part of the whole project as opposed to it just going out on its own. But it's dope because I got to perform it a lot, like a couple months in advance, you know what I mean? I've been performing Yoga Flame and people are like, yo, when are you putting out Yoga Flame? You put out Yoga Flame and whatnot. So it was dope that now it's out. I got all sorts of people like, yo, I've been waiting on this fucking record. You know what I mean? Like doing a thing. And then on top of it, I also had like a Smoking Good record with Lex Luger, and I knew I had the two. So it was like, I was just trying to figure out how to play the two, you know what I mean,
right,
together without people being confused, you know what I mean? The best way for me was just put out the mixtape and let people sit with it, you know what I mean, and choose which one you like better. But like, a lot of people are gravitating towards Yoga Flame, a lot of people towards Smoking Good. Whichever one you like better, I don't give a fuck.
Okay,
you know what I mean?
What does Aaron say?
Well, personally, I like Smoking Good, you know what I mean? I'm riding around on my own shit, you know what I mean? That's how I do, but Yoga Flame, the Street Fighter, it depends on what you like. You like the Street Fighter shit, you know what I mean? You're gonna gravitate towards Yoga Flame, but yeah, I like Smoking Good.
Okay. Now, of course, in terms of the production you have from Snaz to Rich Kid, Trons on there. In terms of the whole body of work for the mixtape, what was it about the producers that made you decide to work?
From the Canadian side, that's just family, you know what I mean? Like, Snaz been blessing me with music, and I just believe in doing so much. Beat Merchant, but blessing me with music. Me and him had our own little riff, you know what I mean? But end of the day, that's my nigga for life, you know what I mean? He's been blessing me with music. Trons, a new kid coming up doing this thing, and like, I'm really trying to showcase some of the new guys, you know what I mean? Like, Trons is super, super, super talented. Like, I see it in him, you know what I mean? So, I'm just trying to put on people from my city, and like, Prologic, that's my engineer, you know what I mean? So like he ain't got no choice but to sneak a record on my project every single time, you know? So the homegrown guy, Rich Kid, that saga bass.
You put ham on those drums,
oh, Rich went stupid on that No Handouts record, you know? So it's all family for me at the end of the day, and like I'm definitely looking forward to working with more Toronto producers and doing shit with more guys from out here, Canadian producers, not just Toronto producers, Canadian producers, and kind of building and showcasing our talent. Like, end of the day, that's what it's about for me. Like, being a Toronto MC, being able to showcase Toronto artists and Toronto producers and beat makers and Canadian beat makers is like, that's what it's about for me at the end of the day, because no one else is gonna do it like I do, you know?
Okay, and of course, live for the moment.
Yeah.
We know what it is behind that, but you know what? You care to address the situation?
Live for the moment. I mean, shout out to the nigga P Rain. Like, I fuck with his record. I mean, for me, it was like I had the record as well. You know what I mean? And I put out the record just because. I'll be honest with you. I was hesitant about putting out the record, but it was one of Ray's favorite records. You know what I mean? That I had done when I met him. It was one of the first records I played for him. You know, and then Rain put out his record, and I was like, shit, I don't know if I should put out mine or whatnot, but. I mean, Ray loved the record so much, I didn't have a choice. You know what I mean? It was like, he's like, yo, nigga, that shit's going out. You know what I mean? So,
that was one of my favorite ones.
Yeah, you know, a lot of people love that record, so it was difficult for me to not put it out. You know what I mean? But shout out to Ray and his whole movement. You know what I mean? No animosity on my end. Like, I mean, take it what it is. If you like my record, you like my record. If you like his record, you like his record. Ain't nothing to me. I mean, this isn't the first time in history that, you know what I mean, that a nigga's put out a record and another nigga's put out a record on the same beat. You consider mine a dub, you consider his a dub. I don't care how you do it. You know what I mean? But yeah, of course, taking both records.
Right. Now, of course, we'll get to the artwork of the movie.
Yeah.
You're on the cover with all the, you know, black market and everything.
Yeah.
What was the whole aspect of that?
Yeah, y'all, shout out Dope Society, you know what I mean? My nigga Tone. I've been working with Tone, you know, lately, last year, 2 years, and just kind of watching him grow as a graphic designer. I wanted to give him a chance to kind of, you know what I mean, do something on another level. So I gave him an opportunity, and he came through in the clutch. Like, it's really, No Handouts, from the artwork to the music, is really just a progression of, like, of J.D. Era, you know what I mean? Like, for me, from Black Market Volume 1, the people that know me that far, to Coming to America, to 13, you know what I mean? And that's what the artwork was about, just kind of showing the progression, you know what I mean, with the collage of my old mixtapes and whatnot. But from Black Market to Ice Age 2O, like, this thing is real, and people saw what I was doing on the Black Market tip. For me to join, you know what I mean, up with a bigger force, you know what I'm saying? I got my nigga Camel with Deep Waters, and we just really trying to create something serious, like a serious movement, you know what I mean, in Toronto that they haven't had before, you know what I mean? Because I'm coming from the West End, he's coming from the East End, and it's on some shit where we're really trying to connect, you know what I mean, and show people that, you know, fuck what end you're from, end of the day, we're representing this Toronto shit, this Ice Age 2O shit, and we're trying to take it to the world. So like, it's either get down or lay down. Niggas ain't getting down, like, straight up, I'm running over niggas. So like, choose it, do it how you want to do it, you know what I mean? If niggas want to get down, more power to you, we're welcoming you, we're embracing niggas. If you don't want to get down, I'm running over niggas. So, that's what it is.
All right, now I want you to describe each of these artists that you work with. One word.
With one word, okay.
Aya,
I call her the voice, you know what I'm saying? Like, Aya, like, I mean, I use more than one word just to say, like, I just, from the gate, I knew she was super talented, you know what I mean? And I've known Aya for years and, like, wanted to work with her for years, you know what I mean? And if you ask her, she'll tell you how hard it was. I chased her to get on this project, you know what I mean? So, just the voice to me, like, she's super talented.
Okay, Lox.
Lox, man. That's my homie right there. Yo, Lox, I call Lox Clutch. Yeah, that's the word I use for him, Clutch. Lox, I never have to guide him on records. You know what I mean? Like, I bring him records and play it for him, and then he comes up with his own shit. You know, Lox is one guy that I can say, like, I play him shit and I trust that Lox is gonna come up with it. You know what I mean? I leave it to him, and he's been clutch for me from 13, before 13. You know what I mean? Niggas know I've been fucking with Lox, so I definitely wanna see him with
Raekwon.
Raekwon, the God. You know what I'm saying? That's my mentor right there. Like, I'm so appreciative of Ray kind of coming into Toronto and giving me an opportunity. Like, real shit, Ray didn't have to do that. And he's been so humble about how he's come into Toronto and worn it on his back. You know what I mean? Like, he's like he came in prouder than most Canadians.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And for me to see that, it's like, fuck, I have no choice but to get in line. You know what I mean? It's like, it's been amazing. And I think people are really starting to see that, and they're seeing like, yo, it's not on some, oh yeah, I love Toronto, but I'm never here.
Yeah.
Or on some, I love Toronto, but I don't talk about it. Like, I was in New York on Power 105, Ray talking about Toronto. I'm at High 97, Ray talking about Toronto. Like, yo, I'm in Toronto, I'm doing this, I got the label, blah, 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 you know? So for me, it's really been unreal, like, to have someone in the city really represented for us, and that shit is like, I'll appreciate that forever, you know what I mean?
Shot Wisdom.
That's my baby girl right there, yo. Shot Wisdom, y'all wanna, yo, I believe in her so much. I love what she does, you know what I mean? I think she's one of the special ones in our city, you know what I mean? Like, and I tell people that shit. I wanna see her grow, you know, for me. I don't know if there's one word I can describe her, but I'm looking forward to seeing her grow as an artist, you know what I mean?
Mac Miller.
Brand new crib. Old ass neighbors, you know what I mean? Mac Miller, yo, he the coolest white boy in the game right now, yo. Shout out Mac Miller, you know, that's Ray's white boy. You know, he said it on the record, like, yo, that's my favorite white boy right there. So, shout out Mac Miller, he came through in the clutch himself. That was like some fourth quarter shit. I had that record, Hate Me Later, sitting for a minute, and he just came in and really blessed it, took us to the next level. I appreciate that.
Last but not least,
The Let Up. Oh man, my girl Sadia. The Let Up. What's the word I would use for them? The future, you know what I mean? Just the sound they have right now, it's an alternative sound that I really love. Having them on Hero was some different shit, you know what I mean? I think if people really sit and take in Hero, the record itself, I think they're gonna really appreciate that record. But The Let Up, I call them the future. Sadia, amazing, amazing vocalist. Shout out to Aiden, you know what I mean? And they got like a little group, they're doing their own thing. But they gave me that record. Hero was their record first. You know what I mean? A lot of people don't know that Hero was their record first. And Snaz had flipped it. He flipped it so crazy that I was like, yo, I gotta body this. I bodied it, brought it back to them, and they heard it and they were like, oh shit. You know what I mean? Like, they had the original and gave me the blessing to put it out. So you know what I did to it. You know what I mean? So definitely go check out Hero. Check out the whole fucking mixtape, man. No handouts. I'm putting out Canadian classics right now. I'm putting out world classics, but I call it a Canadian classic. You know what I'm saying? Representing that Maple Leaf, 416. They can see me out here, you know what I mean? All my 905 niggas will give me all that flack. You know the baby every 905. Shut the fuck up with all that shit, man. You know what the fuck I'm representing. This shit is international. I'm on some worldwide shit. I'm gonna get the 905 in for niggas just to let niggas know it's real. You know what I'm saying? But shout out to everyone from Saga, fucking Ajax.
Yeah.
Shout out to everyone from Poughkeepsie. I was in Pontiac, Michigan.
Yeah.
I was in Lincoln, Nebraska.
Okay.
I was in fucking El Paso, Texas. Niggas, I was representing everywhere on some Canada shit. You know what I mean? And if you don't fuck with me as an artist, you know what I'm saying, on a personal level, that's cool. But I just ask that you respect the movement and what we're doing right now. You know what I'm saying? Because it's not just about me. It's not just about hip-hop in Canada, you know what I'm saying? It's bigger than that. I'm really trying to show the world we got music, you know what I mean? That's from our R&B lane. If rock niggas want to get down, like, I'm fucking with rock niggas. I know you niggas is popping and shit, but I'm fucking with everyone right now. I appreciate Royalty Radio. You guys been showing me love since you guys were born, you know? I feel like a fucking pops right now, like, cradling Royalty Radio, like, yo, feeding you niggas and shit, you know what I'm saying? Like, you guys are family. I appreciate that shit. Shout out to your face. My man Andre 905, Paco, you know what I'm saying? Eddie, the original Ghanaian boy.
Yeah, brother.
Aqua, boy, everyone in Ghana, you know what I'm saying? You know what it is, yeah, man. We represent for real. Like, Canada, I love you guys. Like, if you guys ain't fucking with us, fuck you. Get down and lay down, nigga. You know what it is, man. Ice H2O, Black Market Era. You know what the fuck it is, man. All right,
man. We out, man.
You got any more questions? Can I get some more questions? No handouts that net. You got another question? Give me one more question, man. We good out here.
Some more questions. All right, man. Hero. You're speaking about Hero.
Yeah.
What was it that intrigued you about that traffic?
Man, Hero. Don't be a fucking superhero, man. Too many superheroes out in these streets, man. Fall the fuck back. Stop being a hero. That's what that record's about. You hear? Who to thank? My Sri Lankans running in and out of banks. Oh, that's your boy, man. Black Market Arrow. Shout out my nigga, just can't go. You know what it is, man. Like, honestly, I'm in a good place right now. And like, you can probably see it on my face. I'm smiling and shit. I'm in a good mood. Niggas can't fuck up my mood. a lot of niggas trying to fuck up my mood. You can. Like, straight up, you can fuck up my mood.
Well, shit,
Troll Show Radio, man. You know what I'm saying, man? Every Tuesday, Triple W
on Every Tuesday, and I be showing up on fucking, I pop up on Rose Street. So fuck y'all niggas. I'll fuck around, book one of y'all niggas for an interview and show up. Keep fucking with me, yo. Y'all niggas playing around too much.
Oh, man. You know what it is, man.
Call
me the world, man.
It's the greatest, the greatest, the greatest. I want it all. Come to. This the art of war, niggas, son, too. Bitches wanna kick it like Kung Fu. So if she 21, I